Okay. So moving ahead. We'll go to asset accounting new, and then we were into this integration with GL. So we completed all integrated all acquisition document types. Then we have the next is the specify posting key for asset accounting. What does it mean? Specify posting key for asset accounting. In this activity, define posting key which we are used for automatic posting when posting to fixed assets account. Use the standard SAP key. So this all talks about the keys when you post to fixed asset account. What posting key we want to use. For example, for GL we use 40 for debit and 50 for credit. So similarly, that's what this SAP says. Recommended is use standard SAP posting keys. So let's see what standard SAP keys are. So we have asset posting and then we have 70 and 75. So let's not change this. Let's follow the recommendation from SAP. Change the field status variant for asset GL account. So field status variant, let me give you the background. So I'll show you what it is. So for every GL account, what I did? I didn't did anything. Sorry. Something went wrong. Okay. Zero, zero. Okay. So let's talk about this one. So there is a term called field status variant in GL account. And this is what we have. Okay, now what does it mean? It means when you post to the GL for assets, what will be the fields which will be hidden, what will be the field which will be optional, and what will be the field which are mandatory for the user. For example, to post in any asset account, asset number is mandatory. Okay, to post in asset account, we don't need material number, right? So this basically signifies what is mandatory, what is optional. So let's see what it is. There we have. Let's see the first tab, general data. So you see, assignment number is optional, text is optional, invoice reference is hidden, suppressed means hidden, required means required entry. If I go ahead and see what is mandatory, so all these settlement period, material number, all these are suppressed. But we cannot have asset number suppressed. So let's see where is asset number. Asset number is suppressed. We cannot have asset number suppressed. So what we need to do is we need to change the assignment to asset account. And what will it have? There is no difference. Let's see another one. So we have asset number now optional, so it will be visible on the screen. Okay, so let's save this one with this field status. So field status basically controls the asset number. So now what this option provide is specify posting key. We did change the field status variant for asset GL account. So let's define the variant first, then you change, you so we have G007. We just saw that is okay for us. So our company code is assigned to the right one, field status variant 0001. And here what we do is we will check that what posting key is used for which one. So let's see 70. We just saw the 70 key, right? Debit asset, and that's correct. Okay. The next one is assign input tax indicator for non-taxable acquisitions. So those acquisitions which are not taxable, so we have to assign a tax indicator which would be zero. So here we have input is zero and output would be A0. So these are non-taxable transactions. Okay. The next one is the post depreciation to GL account. Here you determine the document type for each company code for posting depreciation. You must have defined a document number range under document type for entry view. And the standard SAP says the document type for depreciation is AIF. So now the option is either you don't want to use AIF, then ignore it. If you want to use AIF, then keep it as it is. Normally, AF is the one which is normally used. So let's consider that we will go with AF. Then we will go to the specify intervals and posting rules. So how are you posting your depreciation? Is it a monthly posting? Is it a bi-monthly, quarterly, annually? Enter an expert mode. These are all the settings. So normally depreciation is a monthly posting, you know, for every client. So we keep it as a monthly program which SAP runs, because this setting determines, allows you to run the program. If you make it annually, SAP will not allow you to run it during the year. If you run it, say it semi-annually, SAP will not allow you to run it during the month or monthly basis. So the way you specify here, it will control the depreciation program. If you say it monthly here, and if you forget in 1 month, SAP will give you a problem. It says, hey, you forget the last month, because you have given that this setting is monthly, and now you are saying that you want to run it on every second month. This is a problem. So we have to ensure that, you know, this is the right setting as per the industry standard. Normally it is a monthly setting. Okay. Then we have additional account assignment objects. So this is not required actually. So this is what we did with integration of GL account with general ledger. Okay. Let's go to general valuation. The first is set chart of depreciation. So this allows you to set the chart of depreciation for which country you are going to work now. Then we have defined depreciation areas. Let's try to understand what does it mean. Big one.